There's many things that I like to talk about.
Postoji puno stvari o kojima ja volim da pričam.
My favorite thing is to talk about health.
Ali omiljena stvar je zdravlje.
I travel the world talking about alternative and preventive medicine.
Ja putujem po svetu i govorim o alternativnoj i preventivnoj medicini.
But most people want to talk about disease.
Ali većina ljudi voli da govori o bolestima.
How many types of diseases are there?
Koliko različitih vrsta bolesti postoji?
Medical science has put a name to about 100,000 different diseases.
Zdravstvena nauka može da imenuje oko 100,000 različitih bolesti.
I don't know a fraction of those diseases.
Ja ne znam deo tih bolesti.
Because that's not what I study.
Jer to nije ono što ja izučavam.
How many types of perfect health are there?
Koliko tipova savršenog zdravlja postoji?
Yeah, there's just one.
Samo jedno.
I can get my mind around one thing.
Ja mogu da se fokusiram na moj um na jednu stvar.
Is how to establish good health.
Kako da uspostavim dobro zdravlje?
How to maintain good health.
Kako da održim dobro zdravlje?
How to regain good health.
Kako da obnovim dobro zdravlje?
But people like to talk about disease.
Ali ljudi vole da razgovaraju o bolestima.
The number one disease here in Serbia.
I broj jedan bolest u Srbiji.
It's going to be heart disease.
Je bolest srca.
Number two.
Broj dva.
Cerebral vascular disease.
To su moždani udari.
Number three.
Broj tri.
It's going to be cancer.
Će biti rak.
And at number six.
I broj šest.
We got diabetes.
Imamo dijabetes.
Now all of these diseases have one thing in common.
I sve ove bolesti imaju jednu zajedničku stvar.
They're lifestyle diseases.
To su bolesti stila života.
What does that mean?
Šta to znači?
It's the life that we live.
Znači životi kojima mi živimo.
It can prevent the disease.
Može da vas spreči od bolesti.
It can cause the disease.
A može da uzrokuje bolest.
If it causes the disease.
Ako uzrokuje bolest.
By getting back on the right lifestyle,
ako se vratimo na pravi stil života,
we can reverse most diseases.
Možemo da sprečimo većinu bolesti.
We're talking about diabetes today.
Ali danas govorimo o dijabetesu.
Now there are two main types of diabetes.
Postoje dva glavna tipa dijabetesa.
The first one is juvenile diabetes.
Prvi je onaj dečiji dijabetes.
We call it type 1 diabetes.
To je tip 1 dijabetes.
Insulin dependent diabetes.
Znači ljudi koji su ovisni o insulinu.
That's only about 5 to 10% of diabetics.
To je samo 5 do 10% dijabetičara.
So what causes type 1 diabetes?
Šta uzrokuje tip 1 dijabetes?
Many people are going to tell you, well, it's got to be genetics.
Većina ljudi će vam reći da su to geni.
And it's true, there is a genetic component to type 1 diabetes.
I istina jeste da postoji genetska komponenta u tip 1 dijabetesu.
A large study was done using rats.
Veliko istraživanje je učinjeno na miševima.
Now, I know you're not a rat.
Ja znam da vi niste miš.
But they use these experiments with animals before they experiment with humans.
Ali prvo oni eksperimentišu na životinjama, pa onda pređu na ljude.
They got a bunch of rats.
Imali su većinu miševa, gomilu miševa.
And even they can get diabetes.
Čak i oni mogu da dobiju dijabetes.
And they bred them so that they were all genetically or all predisposed to diabetes.
I oni su ih genetski ukrštali tako da su imali i svi su bili nekako predisponirani za dijabetes.
They had the genetics for it.
Imali su gene za to.
And then they had a bunch of baby rats born.
I onda su imali gomilu malih beba miševa koji su rodili.
Divided them into two groups.
Podelili su ih na dve grupe.
The first group.
Prva grupa.
They drank their own mother's milk.
Pili su majčino mleko.
How many got diabetes?
Koliko njih je dobilo dijabetes?
None of them.
Nijedan od njih.
But the other group.
Ali druga grupa.
They were artificially fed cow's milk.
Znači, oni su veštački bili hranjeni kravljim mlekom.
How many of them got diabetes?
Koliko je njih dobilo dijabetes?
Every one of them.
Svaki od njih.
So that sort of led the scientists to validate what they'd already understood.
I to je pomoglo naučnicima da se uveru u ono što su istraživali.
Type 1 diabetes.
Tip 1 dijabetes
is caused by early exposure to cow's milk.
Je uzrokovan preranim ispoljavanjem konzumiranja kravljeg mleka.
Now that's not the only factor.
Ali to nije jedini faktor.
But this is a major factor.
Ali je jedan od glavnih faktora.
Why would that be?
Zašto bi to bilo tako?
Well, there are special cells in our pancreas.
Postoje posebne ćelije u našem pankreasu.
They're made up of 17 amino acids.
koje su stvorene od 17 aminokiselina.
They're the cells that make insulin.
To su ćelije koje prave insulin.
But there's another protein that looks just like it.
Ali postoji još jedan protein koji upravo izgleda kao on.
17 amino acids.
17 aminokiselina.
And what is that one?
Koje su to?
That's casein in cow's milk.
To je kazein u kravljem mleku.
And if a person is allergic or intolerant to cow's milk.
Ako osoba alergična ili netolerantna ka kravljem mleku.
And I would say probably in Serbia 50% of people are.
I ja bih rekao da u Srbiji verovatno oko 50% njih.
The body is going to mount up a defense against casein.
Znači, organizam će stvoriti neku vrstu odbrane od kazeina.
It's going to make an antibody.
Ono će stvoriti antitela.
And it's told to go after casein.
I rečeno će mu biti da ide da juri kazein.
And the body says, what does it look like?
I organizam kaže, kako on izgleda?
It says, look for 17 amino acids.
Kaže, gledaj za 17 aminokiselina.
So they go looking.
I oni krenu da traže.
And they get down to the pancreas.
I oni dođu do pankreasa.
And they see 17 amino acids.
I oni vide 17 aminokiselina.
And they attack it.
I oni ga napadaju.
And they kill the cells that make insulin.
I oni ubijaju ćelije koje prave insulin.
Now what do you have?
I onda šta imate?
That's what we call type 1 diabetes.
I to je ono što zove tip 1 dijabetes.
You killed the ability to make it.
Vi ubijete mogućnost da oni prave.
So, what type of disease is type 1 diabetes?
I kakva vrsta bolesti tip 1 dijabetes?
It's an autoimmune disease.
To je autoimuna bolest.
But here's some good news.
Ali evo dobrih vesti.
Now you talk to almost anybody about type 1 diabetes.
Ali vi pričate sa bilo kom želite o tipu 1 dijabetesu.
They say it's incurable.
Rečeno da ona nije izlečiva.
But in the pancreas.
Ali u pankreasu.
There are other types of cells, they're called beta cells.
Postoje još jedne ćelije, to su beta ćelije.
Now the cells that made the insulin were also beta cells.
Znači, ove ćelije koje prave insulin su isto beta ćelije.
But this is another type of beta cell.
Ali ovo je neka drugi tip beta ćelija.
And it's down there in your pancreas just waiting around for something to happen.
I oni su u pankreasu i čekaju da se nešto desi.
This other one is immune to the system fighting it.
A ovaj drugi je imun na taj sistem koji se bori.
It's not subject to autoimmunity.
I nije uzrokovana autoimunitetom.
You give it the right environment.
Ako mu date pravu sredinu.
That means you're not putting anything in the body that's going to cause the immune system to keep fighting.
Znači, ne stavljate u organizam ono s čime bi se ono borilo.
And these cells learn how to make insulin themselves.
I ove ćelije nauče kako da prave same insulin.
Studies are showing that you can reverse type 1 diabetes.
I istraživanje pokazuje da vi može da sprečite tip 1 diabetes.
They've already done it in animal studies.
Jer su to već učinili na životinjama.
But for right now,
ali za sada,
you gotta keep taking the insulin.
Vi morate da nastavite da koristite insulin.
But even with that, you can make your symptoms lower.
Ali i sa tim vi možete da ublažite simptome.
We'll be talking about that.
Govorit ćemo o tome.
The major type of diabetes is going to be type 2 diabetes.
Znači, glavni tip dijabetesa će biti dijabetes tipa 2.
In a sense, this is not an insulin problem.
I ovo nije problem s insulinom.
Your body's making plenty of insulin.
Vaš organizam pravi dosta insulina.
Matter of fact, your pancreas makes so much, your pancreas is wearing out.
Sorry, pankreas toliko pravi da je on čak i umoran od svega.
So how do you know if you got diabetes?
I kako znate da imate dijabetes?
I'm going to give you a few ways to determine whether you're on your way or you're already there.
I daću vam par načina da vidite da li ste na putu ili niste.
First one.
Prvi.
Your resting glucose, your fasting glucose.
Znači, to je nivo šećera u krvi kada je na tašte.
It should be between 4 and 6.
Treba da bude 4 i 6.
But that just looks back 12 hours.
Ali to gleda samo za njih 12 sati.
There's a better test.
Postoji još bolji test.
Called hemoglobin A1C.
To je hemoglobin A1C.
All right, what that does, it looks back 3 months.
Šta to čini, gleda u poslednje 3 meseca.
Sugar is sticky.
Šećer je lepljiv.
It sticks to the cells.
Lepi se za ćelije.
If you're hemoglobin A1C is between 4 and 5.6.
Ako je hemoglobin A1C između 4 ili 5.6,
you're good.
Vi ste u redu.
If it's 5.7 to 6.4,
ako je 5.7 do 6.4,
there's a name for this.
Postoji naziv za to.
Pre-diabetes.
Pre-diabetičar.
If your doctor ever says those words,
ako doktor kaže ove reči,
at that moment,
u tom trenutku,
you start doing everything I'm going to tell you to do.
Učinite sve što ću vam ja reći danas.
And you will reverse it.
I vi ćete sprečiti taj dijabetes.
But if it's 6.5 or over,
ali ako je preko 6.5,
that's pretty much determined to be diabetes.
I to je već dijabetes.
But there's still hope.
Ali dalje postoji nada.
So that's the first big test.
To je prvi veliki test.
Hemoglobin A1C.
Hemoglobin A1C.
Takes a minute to have the test done.
Potrebno je samo minut da se istestirate.
There's another way to determine whether you're on the way.
Postoji još jedan način kako možete da znate da ste na putu za dijabetes.
Whether you have metabolic syndrome.
Ako imate metabolični sindrom.
You see, type 2 diabetes is not an autoimmune disease.
Znači, tip 2 dijabetes nije autoimuna bolest.
It's a metabolic disease.
To je metabolična bolest.
And there are steps on the way to having this disease.
Postoji koraci koje vode ka toj bolesti.
The first step,
prvi korak,
is going to be overweight.
Biće gojaznost.
If you're overweight, you got to get rid of the extra weight.
Ako ste gojazni, morate da se otarasite viška kilograma.
What's a good way to take care of your weight?
Koji je najbolji način da regulišete vašu telesnu težinu?
Frankly, it's the easiest thing to adjust in the steps towards diabetes.
U stvari, to je najlakši način kako da promenite neke stvari kada rešite da se otarasite dijabetesa.
Whole foods, plant-based diet.
Celovite žitarice sa biljnom ishranom.
Whole grains reduce your risk of diabetes.
Celovite žitarice smanjuju rizik od dijabetesa.
But let's say you're already overweight.
Hajde da kažemo da ste vi već gojazni.
All right, the longer you're overweight, the more you have a chance to get to step number two.
Što duže ste gojazni, bliže ćete doći ka koraku broj 2.
That's carbohydrate intolerance.
To je netolerancija na ugljenohidrate.
What's happening here?
Šta se ovde dešava?
Your body's getting so much food.
Vaš organizam dobija puno hrane.
That's how you got overweight.
Tako ste postali gojazni.
It starts to become intolerant. It will not accept certain foods.
Neće prihvatiti određene namirnice.
Which is going to make you tired all the time.
Što će činiti da ste stalno umorni.
You're going to be confused. You can't think right.
Bićete zbunjeni, nećete moći da razmišljate kako treba.
You got digestive problems.
Imate probleme sa varenjem.
And you crave sweets.
I imate žudnju za slatkom.
But you keep on eating.
Ali vi nastavljate da jedete.
All right, you get to a certain point.
Određene dođete do određene tačke.
The body says, we gotta stop this foolishness.
I telo kaže, ja, mi moramo da prestanemo ovo.
So you go to step three.
I onda te idete na treći korak.
That's called insulin resistance.
To je otpornost na insulin.
Now the body says, you want to keep all this sugar in me?
I sad organizam kaže, ako hoćete da držite ovaj sav šećer u meni,
I'm not going to use it.
Ja ga neću koristiti.
If you look at a plasma cell,
a ako gledate plazma ćeliju,
you got these things called receptor sites.
Ima to je stvari koje zovu receptori.
That's where insulin hooks up with glucose and takes it into the cell.
To je da insulin ga uzima i unosi ga u ćeliju.
Normally, you got 20,000 receptor sites on a cell.
I prosječno imate oko 20.000 receptora na svakoj ćeliji.
But when you get insulin resistance,
ali kada ste otporni insulin,
they start shutting down.
Oni se zatvaraju.
Now you might have 5,000.
Sad možda imate samo 5,000.
No wonder you're tired all the time.
Nije ni čudo što ste stalno umorni.
No wonder you can't think straight.
Nije ni čudo što ne možete da razmišljate kako treba.
You now have insulin resistance.
Sad imate otpornost na insulin.
Next step.
Sljedeći korak.
You got diabetes now.
Imate dijabetes.
Doesn't stop there.
Tu se ne zustavlja.
There's many diseases that will follow.
Postoji puno drugih bolesti koje će slediti.
You don't want diabetes.
Vi ne želite dijabetes.
All right, here's another test you can do at home.
Još jedan test koji možete da učinite kod kuće.
You can't do hemoglobin A1C.
Vi ne možete da uradite hemoglobin A1C.
And basically sometimes it's really hard to tell whether you're into the metabolic syndrome.
I nekada je teško vidjeti da li ste vi u metaboličnom sindromu.
But you can do this.
Ali vi ovo možete učiniti.
Measure yourself around your middle.
I izmerite se oko trbuha.
Best at the level of the belly button.
Najbolje nivo pupka.
Men,
muškarci,
you get 102 centimeters.
Ako imate 102 centimetra,
frankly, that's a whole bunch too much.
Ja mislim da je to malo i previše.
Women, you get 88 centimeters.
Žene 88 centimetara.
That's the first thing.
To je prvi korak.
You just run around there and say, oh, I got it.
I možete izmeriti i kažete, oh, ok, ja sam dobro.
Now I'm going to mention six things.
Ja ću podeliti samo šest stvari.
If you have just one,
ako imate samo jednu od njih,
you're on your way to diabetes.
Vi ste na putu za dijabetes.
Get rid of the gut.
Otrasite se velikog stomaka.
Second thing.
Druga stvar.
It sounds sort of like the first one.
Ja, zvuči kao ovaj prvi.
It's your body shape.
To je oblik vašeg tela.
Are you shaped like an apple?
Da li ste vi u obliku jabuke?
Or you shaped like a pear?
Ili u obliku kruške?
And which one is better?
I koji je bolji?
Well, basically the pear shape is better.
Ja, kruška je bolja.
Better than the apple shape.
Bolja nego jabuka.
But still not the best.
Ali nije najbolje.
Best shape?
Najbolje je.
That would be the banana.
Ovo to bi bilo banana.
You don't need extra weight.
Vama nisu potrebni više kilograma.
So you can do that one very easy, just look in the mirror.
Znači, to možete lako da učinite, pogledajte u ogledalo.
Third test.
Treći korak.
Do a blood pressure.
Izmerite krvni pritisak.
If your systolic is over 130,
ako ste stolični preko 130,
your diastolic is over 35,
diastolni preko 85,
or you're taking blood pressure medications,
ili uzimate lekove za pritisak.
You've got another factor for this problem with diabetes.
Imate još jedan faktor za ovaj problem.
We go to number 4.
Idemo na broj 4.
That's going to be low HDL cholesterol.
Znači, nizak ovaj HDL cholesterol.
You need HDL.
Vama je potreban da je HDL.
It links up with LDL and takes it out of the body.
On ga povezuje sa LDL-om i vadi ga iz organizma.
Number 5.
Broj 5.
That's going to be high triglycerides.
Povišeni trigliceridi.
This comes from refined carbohydrates.
To dolazi iz rafinisanih ugljenohidrata.
Do you have 5 of them yet?
Da li ih imate svih 5?
So only one left.
Samo još jedan ostao.
That is a high fasting blood sugar.
To je jutarnji nivo šećera u krvi pre obroka.
That's number 6.
To je broj 6.
You don't want one of these things.
Vi ne želite ni jedan od ovih.
Now you may say, what, who can do that?
Neko će li, kaže, ko to može da učini?
Healthy people can.
Zdravi ljudi to mogu.
You know, health or sickness is in your hands, not mine.
Zdravlje ili bolest je u vašim rukama, ni u mojim.
I'm just giving you some suggestions.
Ja vam dajem samo neke savete.
Now, we've heard of many types of diets.
Vi ste čuli razne vrste ishrane.
A big popular diet today is called the paleo diet.
I neka jako popularna dijeta danas ishrana je paleo ishrana.
Now, they believe that sometime back in eons of history people lived like cavemen.
I oni veruju da su u nekom vremenskom periodu u istoriji ljudi živjeli kao kameno doba.
They ate bird eggs.
Jeli su ptičja jaja.
Meat from any animal they could catch.
Meso od životinja koje su uhvatili.
Okay. And fruits, vegetables and nuts.
I voće, povrće i orašaste plodove.
My recommendation?
Moj savjet?
Leave out the animal stuff.
Klonite se ovih namirnica životinjskog porekla.
Go with just the plant-based diet.
Idite samo na biljnu ishranu.
What will that do?
Šta će to da učini?
First, it's going to improve your blood pressure.
Prvo, poboljšat će krvni pritisak.
It's going to help you in your insulin secretions.
Znači, smanjit ćete lučenje insulina.
Third thing,
treća stvar,
it's going to make your body more sensitive to the insulin that you are secreting.
Znači, bit će poboljšat će osjetljivost na insulin.
And it's going to improve your blood fats.
I poboljšat će masnoću u krvi.
All of these things right here help you with the diabetes.
Sve ove stvari će vam pomoći kad je u pitanju dijabetes.
And help you with heart disease.
I sa bolesti srca.
And stroke.
I sa moždanim udarom.
And cancer.
I rakom.
They're all in the same family, the lifestyle diseases.
Oni su svi u porodici istih bolesti, bolesti okay. Stila života.
But if you're eating the diet of the civilized society.
Ali ako jedete ishranu civilizovanog društva.
To me it's not a very civilized diet.
Za mene to nije civilizovana ishrana.
I travel all over the world.
Ja putujem po celom svetu.
And this is what I tell my people.
I ovo je što ja govorim ljudima s kojim razgovaram.
If you choose to eat like an American.
Ako izaberete da jedete kao Amerikanci.
You're going to look like an American.
Izgledaćete kao Amerikanci.
You're going to get sick like an American.
Bićeš bolestan kao Amerikanac.
You're going to die like an American.
I umrećeš kao Amerikanac.
My recommendation is stay off the American style diet.
Ja vam savjetujem da se klonite ishrane američke.
I love my country.
Ja volim svoju zemlju.
I hate what we're doing to each other, with each other.
Ja ne volim što radimo jedan drugome.
You get on a high fat western type diet.
Ako ste na ishrani visokih masnoća, zapadnjačkoj ishrani.
It's going to raise your blood pressure.
Ona će povisiti vaš krvni pritisak.
It's going to make your body produce more insulin.
Izgledat će da vaš organizam proizvodi više insulina.
It's going to make you less sensitive to the insulin.
I manje će biti osjetljivi na insulin.
And it's going to raise your blood fats.
I povećat će nivo masnoće.
You don't want any of these things.
Vi ne želite ni jednu od tih stvari.
Some people say, okay, I'll be a vegetarian.
I neki ljudi će reći, okay, ja ću biti vegetarijanac.
But once a month,
jedan put nedeljno bar.
I gotta have some meat.
Moram da imam neko meso.
If you eat one meat meal,
ako jedete samo jedan obrok, mesni obrok,
per month,
mesečno,
it keeps your liver turned up to produce more cholesterol.
Uzrokovat će da dijeta proizvodi više holesterola.
You don't want that.
Vi to ne želite.
Your liver makes all the cholesterol you need.
Vaša dijeta pravi sav holesterol koji je potreban.
You eat animals, you're getting more cholesterol than you need.
Ako jedete životinje, dobijete više holesterola nego što je potrebno.
And then your body produces more.
I vaš organizam proizvodi više.
Okay, now for the third, for the next last test.
I zadnji test.
To let you know whether you're on the road to diabetes.
Da znate da ste na putu za dijabetes.
And this one you can do by yourself.
I ovo možete i sami da učinite.
You see, here's a normal body cell.
I evo normalna ćelija.
And glucose goes into the cell to feed your cell.
I glukoza ide u ćeliju da nahrani.
But if you're insulin resistant.
Ali ako ste odvojeni na insulin.
Glucose can't get in.
Glukoza ne može da uđe.
Now, if the cell's not getting glucose,
ako ćelija ne dobije glukozu,
what's it going to do?
Šta će da učini?
It's going to send a signal.
Poslaće signal.
To the brain.
Mozgu.
And what's that signal going to say?
I šta će taj signal da kaže?
Eat.
Jedi.
We're not getting enough glucose down here.
Nemamo dovoljno glukoze.
And so the person is always hungry.
I osoba je uvek gladna.
All right. Now, if you're always hungry,
ako ste stalno gladni,
you're building up sugar in your bloodstream.
Vi imate više i više šećera u krvotoku.
Because it's not getting into the cells.
Jer nema u ćelijama.
And the body sees this.
I to telo vidi.
And it says, get rid of the sugar.
I kaže, ajmo da se otarasimo šećera.
How does it do that?
Kako će to da učini?
It sends you to the toilet.
Šalje vas na WC.
So you're always going to the bathroom.
I stalno idete u WC.
Always hungry.
Stalno gladni.
Always urinating.
Stalno mokrite.
But that leads to the next symptom.
Ali to vodi do trećeg simptoma.
Your blood is 93% water.
Vaša krv je 93% voda.
And now you start getting dehydrated.
I sad ste dehidrirani.
A message is sent to the brain.
Znači, signal se šalje mozgu.
And what is the message?
I koji je to signal?
Make this fool drink more water.
Neka ova osoba pije više vode.
And you're drinking water all the time.
I stalno pijete vodu.
Do you see it?
Da li vidite?
Three things.
Tri stvari.
Always hungry.
Stalno gladan.
Always thirsty.
Stalno žedan.
Always urinating.
Stalno mokrite.
And it goes around and around and around.
I stalno ide tako krug, krug, krug.
Okay? You got diabetes.
Imate dijabetes.
Oh, but it's in my genes.
Ali to je u mojim genima.
Well, that's another interesting story.
To je još jedna interesantna priča.
There is a group of Indians in what is now the United States.
Postoji grupa Indijanaca koji su, to je sada Sjedinjene Države.
They were farmers.
Oni su bili farmeri.
But about 700 to 1000 years ago the tribe separated.
Ali pre nekih 750 do 1000 godina pleme se razdvojilo.
They were all in the same tribe.
Oni su bili u istom plemenu.
They had the same genetics.
Iste su imali gene.
And half of them stayed in what is now Arizona in the United States.
I polovina ostala u Arizoni u Sjedinjenim Državama.
The other half went down to Mexico, what is now Mexico.
I druga polovina otišla u Meksiko.
The ones who are living in the United States.
Ovi koji žive u Sjedinjenim Državama.
Most of them are overweight.
Većina njih je bilo gojazno.
And over 50% of them have diabetes.
I preko 50% njih imalo dijabetes.
But their cousins across the border.
Ali njihovi rođaci s druge strane granice
with the same genetic makeup.
Sa istim genetskim faktorom
who are farmers.
Koji su farmeri.
Who eat meat once every 1 to 2 months.
Koji jedu meso možda jedan put ili dva put u mesecu.
They work hard.
Oni jako teško naporno rade.
Their diabetes rates.
Njihov nivo dijabetesa.
Less than 10%.
Manje od 10%.
The same genetics.
Isti geni.
What makes the difference?
Šta je razlika?
Is lifestyle.
Stil života.
Okay, now, but our body has to have fuel.
Ali naše telo treba neka vrsta goriva.
Every organ in the body has to have glucose.
Svaki organ u telu mu je potrebna glukoza.
That's glucose.
Ovo je glukoza.
It's a just a natural sugar that's in our foods.
Znači prirodan šećer koji prisutan u namirnicama.
When we eat a meal,
kada jedemo obrok,
our blood becomes sweeter.
Naša krv postaje slađa.
Because blood builds sugar builds up in the blood.
Znači šećer se gomila u krvi.
But that can be a problem.
I to može da bude problem.
The cells inside your blood vessels.
Ćelije unutar krvnih sudova.
They don't need insulin.
Njima nije potreban insulin.
What will that lead to?
Gde će to da vodi?
Tell you in a minute.
Reći vam za minut.
But usually that blood goes to your cells.
Ali polako krv ide u vaše ćelije.
If insulin is working.
Ako insulin radi.
It opens the door, glucose goes in.
Otvara vrata i glukoza ulazi.
The glucose breaks down.
Glukoza se razgrađuje.
Gives you energy.
Da vam energiju.
That's what we need.
To je ono što nam je potrebno.
Okay. But if you have diabetes.
Ali ako imate dijabetes.
There are some complications.
Postoje neke komplikacije.
Now listen to these closely.
Evo slušajte ovo pažljivo.
Because if you have diabetes.
Jer ako imate dijabetes.
And you do not seek to control it.
I ako ne pokušavate da ga kontrolišete.
You've got an appointment with these problems.
Imaćete sastanak s ovim problemom.
Because sugar is going to hurt your entire body.
Jer šećer se će da ošteti celo vaše telo.
Now I mentioned how your sugar builds up in the bloodstream when you eat.
Znači, govorio sam kako se šećer gomila u vašem krvotoku.
You got cells on the inside of your blood vessels.
Imate ćelije unutar krvnog suda.
They need glucose too.
Njima isto potrebna glukoza.
There's a difference.
Postoji razlika.
They don't need insulin to take in the glucose.
Njima nije potreban insulin da bi uzeli glukozu.
So now they can take lots of sugar.
Sad oni mogu da uzmu puno šećera.
Become fat.
Postanu masni.
Sticky.
Lepljive.
That's atherosclerosis.
To je ateroskleroza.
So you don't want to have diabetes.
I vi stvarno ne želite da imate dijabetes.
Now if you have atherosclerosis.
Ako imate aterosklerozu.
That leads to other problems.
To vas vodi do drugih problema.
Increases your risk of heart disease by 2 to 4 times.
Povećava rizik od bolesti srca 2 do 4 puta.
Increases the risk of many types of cancers.
Povećava rizik od raznih drugih tipova raka.
Now, if your cells in your body need sugar.
I ako ćelije u vašem telu, ako mi je potreban šećer.
Cancer cells like sugar even more than your normal cells do.
Znači, ćelije raka vole šećer više nego druge vaše ćelije.
Now a healthy cell, 20,000 receptor sites for insulin.
Znači, zdrava ćelija ima nekih 20,000 receptora za insulin.
If it's a cancer cell.
Ako je ćelija raka.
It will have 15 times more.
Imaće 15 puta više.
You know somebody with cancer?
Ako znate nekog ko ima rak.
No sugar.
Bez šećera.
None.
Ne, nikakav šećer.
Okay, diabetes increases your risk of strokes by 2 to 400%.
Znači, dijabetes utiče da imate veću mogućnost za moždani udar 200 do 400%.
Is the leading cause of blindness in developed countries.
Vodeći uzrok slepila u razvijenim zemljama.
All those fine blood vessels in the back of the eye being destroyed.
To sve one sitne krvni sudovi koji se nalaze u vašem oku.
Increases your risk of kidney disease.
Su uništeni i povećava rizik od bubrežnih bolesti.
You don't want kidney disease.
Vi ne želite bubrežne bolesti.
Yeah. Increases your risk of wounds that will not heal.
Povećava učestalost i mogućnost da se rane ne zatvore.
I want to just tell you about this wound right here.
Želim da nešto kažem o ovoj rani.
She was a patient.
Ona je bila pacijent.
Had a bad diabetic ulcer.
Imala je taj ulkus dijabetični.
You can tell by her leg she was very overweight.
I po njenoj nozi možete da vidite da ona je bila gojazna.
Now the treatment of choice.
Znači, tretman koji se preporučuje u svakom slučaju.
Cut it off.
Odsecite.
We didn't want to do that.
Mi to nismo želeli da učinimo.
We tried everything.
Pokušali smo sve.
One of our doctors putting some very good herbs on it.
I ovaj jedan naših doktora stavlja jednu biljku na to.
Didn't work.
I nije radilo.
finally we found something that worked.
I konačno smo našli nešto što je uspelo da zatvori to.
Cabbage and onions.
Kupus i luk.
Smash them up.
Malo smo ih izackali.
Put them on the wound.
Stavili smo ih na ranu.
In a few months.
I za nekoliko meseci.
That's what the leg looked like.
Ovako je njena noga izgledala.
Pretty amazing stuff.
Neverovatna stvar.
But if you don't heal the wounds.
Ali ako ne izlečite ranu.
It leads to the next problem.
To vodi do sljedećeg koraka.
That's amputation.
To je amputacija.
Leads to impotence in men.
Znači, kod muškaraca vodi do impotencije.
Breast cancer in women.
Rak dojke kod žene.
Diabetes is something you do not want to have.
Dijabetes je nešto što ne želite da imate.
But it's a lifestyle disease.
Ali je to bolest stila života.
So what can you do?
Šta možete da učinite?
Lose the weight.
Izgubite kile.
How do you do that?
Kako to možete da učinite?
Stay away from fat in the diet.
Klonišete se previše masnoće u ishrani.
Now there's many names for diabetes.
Postoji više imena za dijabetes.
People call it sugar diabetes.
Neki ga zovu šećer dijabetes.
Matter of fact, that's what the Latin name means.
U stvari to latinsko ime znači.
But sugar is not the problem.
Ali šećer nije problem.
Sugar is the symptom.
Šećer je simptom.
A large study.
Veliko istraživanje.
A group of people, 65% of their calories coming from fat.
Grupa ljudi koja je konzumila 65% kalorija od masnoća.
Just 2 weeks.
Samo 2 nedelje.
At the end of 2 weeks.
I na kraju 2 nedelje.
Everyone was pre-diabetic.
Svi su imali predijabetično stanje.
Now did they get diabetes?
Kako su dobili dijabetes?
No, when you know you're pre-diabetic.
Već kad znate da ste predijabetičari.
You get off the fat.
Vi klonite se masnoća.
What fat?
Kakvih masnoća?
Butter and margarine.
Puter, margarin.
Fried foods.
Pržena hrana.
Well, there's not much fat in fried foods.
Nema puno masnoće u prženoj hrani.
If you're eating fried foods.
Ako jedete prženu hranu.
You might as well just drink the oil.
Onda vam je isto to kao da i pijete ulje.
Because it's full of it.
Jer je puno njega.
Our salad oils.
Naše ulje za salate.
Our cooking oils.
Naše ulje za kuvanje.
If you are overweight.
Ako ste gojazni.
If you had diabetes.
Ako imate dijabetes.
You don't need any.
Vama nije potrebno ništa od toga.
You say, well, can I have any fat in my diet?
Onda se pitate, da li mogu neke masnoće da imam u ishrani?
Yes.
Da.
The way God made it.
Način na koji ih je Tvorac stvorio.
Eat the olives.
Jedite masline.
Eat the corn.
Jedite kukuruz.
Eat the sunflower seeds.
Suncokretove semenke.
You don't need the oil from these things.
Nije vam potrebno ulje od ovih stvari.
Especially the avocado. I love the avocado.
Pogotovo avokado. Ja volim avokado.
What else can you do for diabetes?
Šta možete još da učinite za dijabetes?
Get more sunshine.
Izlažite se više sunčevoj svetlosti.
Most people who have diabetes have low levels of vitamin D.
Većina ljudi koji imaju dijabetes imaju nizak nivo vitamina D.
60% of people with diabetes.
60% njih.
Raise your vitamin D.
Dignite nivo vitamina D.
How do you do that?
Kako to možete učiniti?
Get out in the sunshine.
Izlažite se suncu.
Oh, but sunshine causes cancer.
Ali sunce prouzrokuje rak.
Only if you burn your skin.
Jedino ako izgorite vašu kožu.
And you're on a high fat diet.
Iako ste na kako jedete namirnice koje imaju dosta masnoće.
Get a half hour of sunshine a day.
Znači izlažite se pola sata na suncu svaki dan.
Covering about 20% of your body.
Što će pokriti neki 20% vašeg tela.
Your arms and your face.
Znači ruke i lice.
You'll get your vitamin D.
I imaćete vitamin D.
Control your weight.
Kontrolišite vašu telesnu težinu.
Best way to do that?
Najbolji način.
Get off the animal products.
Klonite se namirnica životinskog porekla.
Eat a whole food plant-based diet.
Jedite kompletno biljnu ishranu.
Eat nothing after 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Nemojte ništa jedete posle 3 popodne.
Say, I gotta get 3 meals before 3?
Kaže da moram da jedem 3 obroka pre 3 popodne.
No, you eat 2 meals a day.
Ne, jedite 2 obroka na dan.
Can you survive on 2 meals a day?
Da li možete da preživite sa 2 obroka na dan?
I've been doing it for well over 30 years.
Ja to već činim zadnjih 30 godina.
Now I know I look thin.
Ja znam da ja izgledam mršavo.
I've always been thin.
Ja sam uvek bio mršav.
I'm just blessed that way.
Ja sam tako blagoslovljen.
If you want to lose weight?
Ako želite izgubite kile?
Nothing between meals.
Ništa između obroka.
Well, you can have something between meals.
Znači možete nešto da imate između obroka.
That's water.
To je voda.
And nothing but water.
I ništa osim vode.
Okay? Many people have sedentary lifestyles.
Puno ljudi ima sedelački život.
That will give you diabetes and heart disease.
To će vam dati dijabetes i bolesti srca.
So how much exercise do you need?
I koliko fizičke aktivnosti vam je potrebno?
If you do just 30 minutes of exercise a day.
Ako radite baš 30 minuta fizičke aktivnosti na dan.
Reduce your weight 5 to 10%.
Smanjujete težinu 5 do 10%.
You can reduce your risk of diabetes by 58%.
Možete umanjiti rizik od dijabetesa 58%.
Now what if you already have diabetes?
Tako već imate dijabetes.
Do the same thing.
Uradite istu stvar.
Because the treatment is the same as the prevention.
Znači da tretiranje bolesti isto kao i prevencija za bolest.
Okay? Can we treat diabetes once we already have it?
Da li možemo da tretiramo dijabetes jednom kad dobijemo?
Yeah. Plant-based diet.
Biljna ishrana.
I've worked with many diabetics.
Ja sam radio sa dosta dijabetičara.
One thing I like to do is at the beginning put them on a total salad diet.
I ono što ja volim da radim s njima je da ih stavim na ishranu koja će samo se sačinjavati od salata.
Now, the lettuce here in Serbia is the best I've ever had.
Znači, zelena salata koju sam ja imao ovde u Srbiji je najbolje koju sam igde jeo.
But here's the problem.
Ali evo gde je problem.
We put salad oil all over it.
Mi stavljamo ulje na sve to.
Squeeze a lemon on it.
Iscedite limun.
This is, if you eat this type of a diet.
Ako jedete ovu vrstu ishrane.
5 days.
5 dana.
You're going to get your glucose under control.
Imaćete glukozu pod kontrolom.
Then you increase fiber in the diet besides the salads.
I onda još dodate vlakna u vašu ishranu osim salate.
The more fiber reduces the rate in which your glucose rises in your body.
Znači što više vlakana imate, to će ubrzanost povećanja šećera u krvi usporiti.
All of our diabetics get legumes every meal.
I svi naši dijabetičari jedu mahunarke za svaki obrok.
Not a great big pile of them.
Ne znači veliku gomilu.
Just a few.
Ali određenu količinu.
Legumes are high in fiber.
Mahunarke imaju dosta vlakana.
It releases the glucose slowly.
Ono otpušta glukozu polako.
Much better for your body.
Puno bolje za vaše telo.
Okay? Another interesting study that was done.
Još jedno interesantno istraživanje učinjeno.
Over 64,000 women in this study.
Preko 64,000 ljudi u tom istraživanju.
Okay? They looked at them for about 4.5 years.
I gledali su ih 4,6 godina.
And here is their conclusion.
I evo njihov zaključak.
Those who ate legumes every day.
Oni su konzumirali mahunarke svaki dan.
In particular soybeans.
Naročito soju.
Greatly reduce the risk of type 2 diabetes.
U velikoj meri su smanjili rizik od tip 2 dijabetesa.
Now again, that's your prevention.
Ali ovo je jedna prevencija.
But it's also your treatment.
Ali ovo je jedna vrsta iz tretmana.
A study was done with type 1 and type 2 diabetics.
Istraživanje rađeno sa tip 1 i tip 2 dijabetičarima.
Remember I mentioned earlier that this is going to be good for type 1s too.
Znači, rekao sam da bi ovo bilo dobro i za tip 1 dijabetičara.
They took these two groups of type 1 and type 2 diabetics.
Uzeli su dve grupe ljudi, tipa 1 i tipa 2.
For 6 weeks.
6 nedelja.
They put them on the typical diabetic diet.
Stavili su ih na tipičnu dijabetičarsku ishranu.
With beans added.
Sa dodatim pasuljem.
At the end of the 6 weeks.
Posle 6 nedelja.
Their urinary glucose output was down.
I njihovo lučenje glukoze se smanjilo.
Their average cholesterol levels had gone down.
Nivo holesterola se smanjio.
Okay. Your average blood glucose was down.
Znači, prosečan nivo glukoze se smanjio.
All lower than people on just the regular diabetic diet.
Manje nego ljudima koji su bili na regularnoj dijabetičarskoj ishrani.
Now, I don't know how it is here in Serbia.
A ja ne znam kako ovde u Srbiji.
But I know there's a special diet they put diabetics on in the United States.
Ali znam da postoji određena ishrana na koju oni stavljaju dijabetičare.
It's basically 5 to 6 meals a day.
To je obično 5 ili 6 obroka na dan.
It wears the pancreas out.
To izmuči, istroši pankreas.
What are they trying to accomplish with this?
Šta pokušavaju da uspeju s tim?
Well, they know there's insulin resistance.
Znaju da su otporni insulin.
So they're trying to get plenty of glucose in the bloodstream so there's always glucose available.
i oni pokušavaju da gurnu što više glukoze u krvo tog da ona bude spremna.
But that was the original problem.
Ali to je bio originalni problem.
So much glucose.
Toliko glukoze.
The body says we're not going to take anymore.
Organizam kaže i vi ne, mi više nećemo da uzmemo.
If we have a type 2 diabetic.
Ako imamo tip 2 dijabetičara.
That's overweight.
Koji je gojazan.
And they normally are.
I oni obično to jesu.
5 days.
5 dana.
They fast.
Oni poste.
Now we monitor them very closely.
Mi ih pažljivo sagledavamo.
Taking their glucose few times a day.
Merimo glukozu par puta na dan.
Blood pressure all during the day.
Krvni pritisak u toku dana.
At the end of 5 days.
Na kraju 5 dana.
Their glucose is down to normal.
Njihov nivo glukoze je normalan.
And their insulin is now being accepted more readily by the cells.
I sada insulin je puno prihvatljiviji od strane ćelija.
Why?
Zašto?
Because it sees the need now.
Jel vidi potrebu sada?
It doesn't need all that glucose all the time.
Nije mu potrebna sva ta glukoza.
And with high fiber, it's slowly going up and slowly coming down.
I sa dosta vlakana, ona se polako penje i polako silazi.
Stay away from tobacco.
Klonite se duvana.
That's the worst thing you can do if you have diabetes.
To je najgora stvar koju možete učiniti za dijabetes.
Why would that be?
Zašto bi to bilo?
When you smoke a cigarette.
Kada pušite cigarete.
On the inside of your arteries there's a nice muscle layer.
Unutar vaših natrija, arterija postoje jedni mišići.
The nicotine paralyzes your vascular system.
Znači, nikotin paralizuje vaš vaskularni sistem.
You've already got a problem with the diabetes messing with your vascular system.
Već imate problem s dijabetesom koji uzrokuje probleme vaskularnog sistema.
Now you're adding nicotine to the problem.
Sada dodajete nikotin.
It's going to make your body stimulate more insulin production.
I to će da kreira da vaš organizam još više proizvodi insulina.
Insulin makes you hungry.
Insulin čini da ste gladni.
But you can't get into the cells.
Ne može da uđe u ćelije.
So your glucose goes up, your insulin goes up.
Znači vaša glukoza ide gore, vaš insulin ide gore.
Your hunger goes up.
Vaša glad se povećava.
Your diabetes gets worse.
I imat ćete pogoršanje dijabetesa.
Another thing you do not want to do.
Još jedna stvar koju ne želite da učinite.
Don't get upset.
Ne ljutite se.
What does that do?
Šta će to da učini?
When you become upset.
Kada ste ljuti.
It's a stress reaction.
To je reakcija na stres.
So what's going to happen?
Šta će da se desi?
You got your kidneys back there.
Vaši bubrezi.
And on top sets your adrenal glands.
Su iznad njih su nadbubrežne žlezde.
When you get mad,
kad ste ljuti,
it releases adrenaline.
Ono izlučuje adrenalin.
First thing it's going to do.
Prvu stvar koju će da učini.
If you eat a meal today.
Ako jedete obrok danas.
You ate more than you really needed.
Pojeli ste malo više nego što vam potrebno.
The extra glucose can be stored as glycogen.
I ekstra glukoza će biti skladištena kao glikogen.
That'll be in your liver.
To će biti u vašoj jetri.
It'll be in your muscles.
I vašim mišićima.
But when the adrenal glands put out adrenaline.
I kada nadbubrežne žlezde izluče adrenalin.
All that glycogen becomes glucose.
Taj glikogen postaje glukoza.
There goes your glucose levels.
I evo odlazi vaš visok nivo glukoze.
Don't get upset.
Ne ljutite se.
Now that's easy to say, hard to do sometimes.
A nekad je to puno lakše reći nego raditi.
So you make the lifestyle changes.
I vi promenite neke stilove života.
Do they really have an effect upon the body?
Da li oni stvarno utiču na telo?
Two case histories.
Dva slučaja.
The first person.
Prva osoba.
Type 2 diabetic.
Tip 2 dijabetičar.
Very overweight.
Jako gojazan.
Which is usually going to be the case with type 2 diabetics.
Što će obično biti slučaj sa tip 2 dijabetičarima.
When he checked in.
Kad je on došao kod nas.
He was taking 175 units of insulin a day.
On je uzimao 175 jedinica insulina na dan.
But still his glucose was way, way high.
Ali dalje njegova glukoza bila jako visoka.
Okay. He'd already had two heart attacks.
I već je imao dva srčana udara.
Remember we said that diabetes leads to 2 times more heart attacks.
I govorili smo da dijabetes povećava uzrok 2 do 4 puta.
He was on high blood pressure medication.
On je bio na lekovima za visok pritisak.
His cholesterol was very high.
Njegov kolesterol je bio visok.
And his kidneys were failing.
I njegovi bubrezi su otkazivali.
First thing we did?
Prva stvar koju smo učinili?
5 days fast.
Postili smo 5 dana.
At the end of those 5 days,
na kraju tih 5 dana,
glucose down between 80 and 120.
Glukoza je bila između 80 do 120.
He lost 4.5 kilos.
Izgubio je 4,5 kilograma.
He was down to 130 units of insulin.
I sad je bio na 130 jedinica insulina.
2 weeks later,
dve nedelje kasnije,
he had lost 7 kilos.
On je izgubio 7 kilograma.
Down to 58 units of insulin.
Sad je bio na 58 jedinica insulina.
1 month later,
jedan mjesec kasnije,
he was on no insulin.
Nije bio na insulinu.
He had lost 11 kilograms.
Izgubio 11 kilograma.
And he was on no blood pressure medication.
I nije koristio lekove za pritisak.
Why?
Zašto?
His blood pressure was under control.
Njegov pritisak je bio pod kontrolom.
If you can lose just 5 kilos, just 1 kilo.
Ako izgubite samo 1 kilo.
You can reduce your blood pressure significantly.
Vi možete da smanjite vaš pritisak dosta.
Why?
Zašto?
For every extra kilo of weight you have in your body.
Za svaki ekstra kilogram koji imate u vašem telu,
your body makes 3 kilometers of blood vessels.
Vaš organizam pravi 3 kilometra krvnih sudova.
That means the heart's got to work harder.
To znači da će srce raditi jače.
At this point, the man went home.
U tom trenutku je osoba otišla kući.
That's sometimes the hardest part.
To je nekada najteže.
Because now he's on his own.
Sad je on sam.
But he was serious.
Ali on je bio ozbiljan.
And he stayed with the program.
I on je ostao na programu.
5 months after he had gone home, after he started the program,
5 mjeseci pošto je otišao posle program kad završio,
he was on no medications.
Nije više bio na lekovima.
Blood pressure was perfect.
I pritisak je bio odličan.
Lost 27 kilos.
Izgubio 27 kilograma.
And his kidneys were working perfectly.
I njegovi bubrezi su radili savršeno.
What changed?
Šta se promenilo?
His medication.
Njegovi lekovi?
No, his lifestyle.
Ne, njegov stil.
So all it takes.
To je sve što je potrebno.
Second man.
Drugi čovjek.
He was a type 1 diabetic.
Bio je tip 1 dijabetičar.
He was taking he was a little bit high on weight.
Malo više bio gojazan.
Taking 70 units of insulin.
Uzimao je 70 jedinica insulina.
Glucose very unstable.
Glukoza je bila nestabilna.
2 weeks later.
Dve nedelje kasnije.
Now here's an important point.
I evo je neka važna tačka.
You have a type 1 diabetic.
Ako imate tip 1 dijabetes.
They cannot fast.
Oni ne mogu da poste.
3 meals.
3 obroka. Jesu u redu.
Okay. But it's got to be high fiber meals.
Ali moraju da budu namirnice koje imaju dosta vlakana.
No fat meals.
Bez masnoća.
That's what he had at our institution.
To je on imao u našem centru.
2 weeks later.
Dve nedelje kasnije.
Down to 56 units of insulin.
Koristio 56 jedinica insulina.
Glucose was stable.
Glukoza je bila stabilna.
And he had lost 5.8 kilos.
Izgubio je 5,8 kilograma.
1 month later.
Mjesec dana kasnije.
Down to 32 units of insulin.
Je imao 32 jedinice insulina koristio.
That's about as low as you can get for a type 1 diabetic.
To je možda najniže što može da postanete sa tip 1 dijabetičarom.
Glucose was stable.
Glukoza je bila stabilna.
Lost 10.4 kilos.
Izgubio je 10,4 kilograma.
And all he did was change his lifestyle.
I sve što je učinio je promijenio stil života.
Very simple things to do.
Jednostavna stvar koju može da učini.
You know, today, in today's world,
u današnjem svetu,
glucose is a pandemic.
Glukoza je na pandemija.
There are places I go, though, that I don't find diabetes.
Postoje mjesta gdje ja putujem, gdje ja ljude ne vidim da imaju dijabetes.
I've done a lot of work in Africa.
Radio sam puno u Africi.
I don't find diabetes there.
Tamo dijabetes nije prisutan.
Unless I go to the cities.
I jedino ako ne odem u gradove.
In Zambia?
U Zambiji?
I don't find any diabetes out in the bush.
Ja ne mogu nigdje dijabetes da nađem u negdje u divljini.
Going to the capital, Lusaka.
Ako odem u Lusaku, glavni grad,
where they live just like the rest of the West,
gdje žive kao ostatak zapadnog sveta,
they've got the disease.
Oni imaju tu bolest.
But it's a lifestyle disease.
Ali je to bolest stila života.
We need to start changing our lifestyles.
Mi moramo da krenemo da menjamo na životni stil.
Many people listening to this broadcast right now,
i puno ljudi koji slušaju ovaj program sada,
have an appointment with diabetes.
Imaju jedan sastanak sa dijabetesom.
Which means they also have an appointment with heart disease.
Što znači da imaju jedan sastanak i sa bolestima srca.
With strokes.
Sa moždanim udarom.
With cancer.
Sa rakom.
With wounds that will not heal.
Sa ranama koje ne mogu da zarastu.
It's a choice that we make.
To je izbor koji mi pravimo.
I've worked with many types of diseases.
Radio sam sa raznim vrstama bolestima.
I've always found that the easiest one to work with is diabetes.
I sadno sam zaključio da je najlakša bolest koja može se raditi dijabetes.
But there's one important factor.
Ali postoji jedan glavni faktor.
The person has to be serious.
Osoba mora da bude ozbiljna.
And when I have a serious patient,
i kad imam osobu koja je ozbiljna,
who will do everything I say,
koja će učiniti sve što ja kažem,
the very simple things that I suggest,
i jednostavne stvari koje ja preporučujem,
have a profound effect,
imaju neverovatan uticaj.
So let me just summarize some of the basics.
Evo samo da sumiram neke osnovne stvari.
If you know somebody with type 1 type 2 diabetes.
Ako znate nekog ko ima tip 2 dijabetes.
Well, let's include type 1 with them too.
Ali možemo da uračunamo i tipa 1 u to.
First thing.
Prva stvar.
They've got to exercise.
Oni moraju da budu fizički aktivni.
And it's best to exercise outside in the sunshine.
I puno je bolje da su fizički aktivni napolju na suncu.
Vitamin D goes up.
Vitamin D se povećava.
Blood pressure goes down.
Krvni pritisak se smanjuje.
How much exercise?
Koliko fizičke aktivnosti?
As much as a person can do.
Koliko god osoba može.
Second thing.
Druga stvar.
A plant-based whole foods diet.
Biljna ishrana.
Stay away from the fats.
Klonite se masnoće.
Okay? Third thing.
Treća stvar.
Drink water.
Pijte vodu.
What does water do?
Šta voda čini?
If you're not drinking enough water,
ako ne pijete dovoljno vode,
your insulin does not work properly.
Vaš insulin ne radi kako treba.
So have them drinking plenty of water.
Znači, učinite da oni piju dosta vode.
Now, diabetes is an inflammatory process.
Znači, dijabetes je jedan upalni proces.
And there's a way to measure that in the bloodstream.
I postoji način kako možete to da izmerite u krvotoku.
It's called C-reactive protein.
To je CRP.
It's a blood test.
To je test krvi.
If it's high,
ako je visok,
that means you got inflammation.
To znači da imate upalu.
Interesting study on this.
Interesantno istraživanje na tome.
Those people who attend church on a weekly basis,
osobe koje idu u crkvu svake nedelje,
have low levels of that protein.
Imaju niži nivo tog proteina.
It doesn't mention which church it is.
Čak ne pominje koju crkva.
Just if you have faith in somebody outside of yourself.
Samo ako imate veru van onoga ko ste sami sebe.
Do those simple things.
Učinite jednostavne stvari.
Now I got to mention one other thing.
Moram da pomenem samo još jednu stvar.
I like to do simple treatments.
Ja volim da radim neke jednostavne tretmane.
And I do a lot of hydrotherapy.
I radim dosta hidroterapije.
But this can be a danger for diabetics.
Ali ovo može da bude opasno za dijabetičare.
Especially when their circulatory system is not working properly.
Pogotovo kad njihova cirkulacija ne radi kako treba.
That's why their wounds don't heal.
Zato njihove rane ne zarastaju.
You gotta have good circulation to heal a wound.
Vi morate imati dobru cirkulaciju da bi rana zarasla.
And so if you take, let's say you've got a diabetic patient.
Ajde kažemo da imate pacijenta koji ima dijabetes.
It's winter time.
I u toku zime.
They're cold.
Hladno im je.
Now, a great way to warm a person up is put their feet in hot water.
Najbolji način da zagrijete osobu da stave stopalo u toplu vodu.
You don't do that with a diabetic.
To ne radite sa dijabetičarom.
Why is that?
Zašto je to?
When you heat something.
Kada nešto zagrijete,
chemical reaction speeds up.
Dolazi do ubrzane hemijske reakcije.
Okay, there's a law of chemistry.
Postoji neki zakon hemije.
So if you put a person's feet in hot water,
ako stavite osobu stopala u toplu vodu,
two problems.
Dva problema.
One, they don't feel as well as you do. They don't have the sense of heat.
Oni ne osjećaju tu toplotu kako bi trebalo.
You could burn them.
Možete da ih sagorite, izpečete.
But the second problem is even worse.
Ali drugi problem je još veći.
Remember we talked this about a metabolic situation.
Govorili smo o onom metaboličnom situaciji.
Glucose is down there going into the cells.
Glukoza ide u ćelije.
It breaks down.
Razlaže se.
Into three things.
U tri stvari.
Water.
Voda.
Carbon dioxide.
Ugljen monoksid.
And energy.
I energija.
Okay. Energy is great.
Energija je odlična.
Water is great.
Voda je isto dobra.
But that carbon dioxide.
A ovo je carbon monoksid.
Not so nice.
Nije najbolje.
Body doesn't like that.
Organizam to ne voli.
That's why every time you breathe out, carbon dioxide is getting out.
I svaki put kada izdahnete, ugljen monoksid izađe.
But now, think about this.
Ajde sad razmislite o ovome.
You put somebody's feet in hot water.
Stavite nečije stopalo u toplu vodu.
They have poor circulation.
Imaju lošu cirkulaciju.
That's a problem with diabetics.
To je problem sa dijabetičarima.
But now the heat speeds up the breakdown of the glucose.
Ali sada to blato ubrzava razlaženje glukoze.
Loss of energy.
Puno energije.
Loss of water.
Puno vode.
Loss of carbon dioxide.
Puno karbon, ugljen monoksida.
But because of the circulatory problems, the carbon dioxide cannot be carried off so fast.
Ali zbog tih svih granih problema, ugljen monoksid ne može da se odnese.
So what happens?
Šta se dešava?
You start building up carbon dioxide.
Pokušava da se gomila ugljen monoksid.
What's going to happen?
Šta će se desiti?
Well, what's going to happen if you close off your room?
Šta će desiti ako zatvorite vašu sobu?
No air can come in your room anyway. You got everything, every coal is stuffed up.
Znači, ne može nikakav vazduh da uđe u vašu sobu. Sve je zatvoreno.
What's going to happen?
Šta će se desiti?
You're going to die.
Umrećete.
Because you can't live on carbon dioxide.
Jer ne možete da živite na ugljen monoksidu.
Neither can your feet.
Ni vaša stopala.
So as that carbon dioxide builds up,
i kada se dođe do gomilanja ugljen monoksida,
it starts to kill healthy tissue.
On ubije zdrave ćelije.
I've known cases like this.
Zdravo tkivo. Ja znam slučajeve takve.
When you kill off the tissue,
kada tkivo odumre,
it doesn't grow back.
Ne raste ponovo.
And they have to amputate.
I morate da ga amputirate.
Be careful with heat with diabetics.
Pazite se toplote kod dijabetičara.
You know, diabetes is a lifestyle choice.
Dijabetes je izbor životnog stila.
If you see the problem ahead of you,
ako vidite problem ispred vas,
and we talk about diabetes,
govorili smo o dijabetesu,
it could be heart disease,
može bude bolest srca,
could be cancer,
ili rak.
When you see that, that could be in your future,
ako vidite da bi to moglo da bude u budućnosti,
a wise man makes some adjustments in their lives.
Znači, mudri čovjek se učiniti neke promjene u životu,
a foolish man goes right on into it.
A onaj koji nije mudar će ići dalje u njih.
It's a choice we make every day.
To je izbor koji pravimo svaki dan.
You know, our whole life is about making choices.
Naš ceo život je u pravljenju izbora.
You know, I've got a computer here.
Ja imam ovdje kompjuter.
It works with a special language.
Radi na jednom posebnom jeziku.
It's called binary. Zeros and ones.
Nula i jedan.
On and off.
Uključiš i isključiš.
Our whole life is like this.
Naš ceo život je tako.
Every day you've got choices to make, hundreds and hundreds of choices.
Svaki dan vi stotine izbora raznih pravite.
I've made some recommendations.
Ja vam preporučujem neke savete.
You're at the crossroads now.
Mi smo sad na raskrsnici.
One goes to health.
Jedan ide ka zdravlju.
One goes to disease.
Jedan ka bolesti.
And you're the only one that can change that picture.
I vi ste jedini koji može promijeniti tu sliku.
Take the right path.
Uzmite, idite pravim putem.
I don't want you as my patient.
Ja vas ne želim kao moje pacijente.
I've treated too many people.
Ja sam tretirao puno ljudi.
Which diseases were their choice.
Jer je bolest bila njihov izbor.
So we got to sit down today.
Moramo sednemo danas.
And say, is it worth it?
Da li vredi to?
Can I do this?
Da li ja mogu ovo da učinim?
Let me tell you something.
Evo reći vam nešto.
If you think you can do something,
ako mislite da možete nešto da učinite,
you're right.
U pravu ste.
You can.
Vi to možete.
But if you think you cannot do something,
ali ako mislite da te ne možete,
you're right.
U pravu ste.
You cannot.
Vi to ne možete.
It begins in your mind.
Počinje u umu.
Fight this thing right now.
Borite se s njim sada.
You start fighting diabetes right now when you're healthy.
Borite se s dijabetesom sad dok ste zdravi.
You'll never get it.
I nikad ga nećete dobiti.
I'm almost 71.
Ja ću skoro biti 71 godinu.
I don't worry about these diseases.
Ja se ne bojim tih bolesti.
I've chosen to live the life.
Ja sam izabrao da živim život.
You choose also.
I vi to isto izaberite.
Thank you.
Hvala.